Good morning all. Today I will be taking a class regarding the another category. So please take time to read this question. Once it is done, you can tell me. Can you identify which question it is, which category? Is it discharge letter?
It does. It is a referral letter.
Okay. Here also you can read. Discharge.
Discharge plan.
Actually, the problem with one, why I particularly asked which category it belongs, actually there is a trap over there. See, we can see over here it's a referral letter, and over here also it's written clearly referral letter. But one thing you have to, but here one word, have you noticed, this is a transfer. But now they have given two words, transfer as well as referral letter. Now we are in a confused state. Which letter it could be. So here it's written retirement home. So it's like write a referral letter to Mrs. Jansen, resident warden. So that patient is now going to this retirement home. So in that cases, what I have noticed is that it is mostly transfer letter. So only in the one place, two places it's mentioned referral letter, but one word transfer. But when I compared with the retirement home, at that time almost retirement home is coming as a transfer letter only. And some most often even any road accidents or something, it could be transfer letter. There are no other ways I can explain. Keep in mind, retirement home, then they don't have further treatment over there, they only will be taking care of them. So that means they are transferring, not referring. Referring means they will be getting additional treatment, much more facilities will be available.
Some further treatment.
Yes, that's the reason. But there might be, see, my students are from different institutions, already studied in multiple institutions, different years in OIT experience studying. So in each institution they might be telling the reason, different reason that could be. But from my observation, I understood that most retirement home means it will be this transfer letter. So don't fall for this speech. So now we know this patient is an accident case, and we read this discharge plan. So did you read this? No, right, you can read. No. Once it is done, please tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then I will show the questions completely and then I will explain the questions. So what is important? Diagnosis is important. So it's like now I will explain the discharge plan. Okay, there will be, I told you there will be several points which will be repeating over and over again. So you should keep that in mind. Are you able to figure out some points at least from your experience so far?
Physiotherapy.
Yes.
ADL.
Okay.
Wound care.
Yes.
That's what I get now.
Okay. So from your few classes experience, you were able to identify, and if you have a good note with you, within you don't have to think, and you have sentence also will be ready. See, current medication earlier transferred to in retirement home. It is arranged by, already arranged by some social worker to move on any date. Then see, there is a trap over here also. See, it's a patient instructed on. So already the instruction is given. It's not like instruction is going to given. So already during hospitalization, they have given the instructions. So you can include that this particular one sentence, this points in the during hospitalization in the middle paragraph. So in the last paragraph, you can avoid this and you can include this point to other paragraphs. So it will be much more in an order way, because here they will be writing some point like patient instructed on, patient given instruction, which means past tense. So pay attention to that. Now, as you told, ADL is a common point, showering, dressing. See, showering, same vocabulary only, same points repeating. Then, wound point, dressing, clean and dry. So you know the sentence itself. Physiotherapy, a common point, range of motion, achieve full motion. This is a common thing. And sometimes even in the accident, if several accidents, there could be some similar points, because mostly in the accident they will be having the fracture problem related to bone. So then discharge plan, everything could be normal. Here one specialty is that ADL is usually we will be telling we have to provide assistance, but here we are telling do encourage to carry out ADLs independently. That is one different point. Encourage, we have to encourage. So what is the synonym for that? Encourage means motivate. Okay, when if it's written here encouragement, you will be writing motivate over there. Now patient discharge education, see, no lifting. This is a common point, no lifting, weight bearing. Physiotherapy outpatient is a common point. 9 days post-operative. On one question is the 10, after 10 days. Here it is 9 days. So they change the date, that's it, number of days. At orthopedic outpatient, it's a common pain. Someone should be accompanied. Accompany is a common point. So since now you told 3 points is common from your experience, from your observation, but I told some more points. Please make a list of that and have that notes with you. It will be helpful. Okay. Now come to medications. See, something. Two drugs name has been given. For some drug, they will be specifically telling some points. Okay, here it is as required. So it's not like that whenever they want, they can have as required. That's something they have written over here. See, the one same medicine, naproxen, is even repeating over here. Can you notice? Sometimes some medicine will be repeating. especially analgesia, because if they have pain, then only they have to have. In that case, it's like how we can write. Now that's a question for us. Okay, so now we will be nursing management. Can you please read in on your mind? Which point you will be taking from here? Will you take this point within normal range?
Within normal range, no need to take the.
No need to take. So, ADL assistance is a common point. This leg dressing changed regularly. Now removed. Now the dressing is completely removed. During hospitalization, wound dressing was there. Now we don't need. Okay, so during hospitalization, in that paragraph, if you want, you can write. Otherwise, just avoid that. Later, we don't need that wound dressings. So, cold
can we mention that this removal?
Yes, yes, you can mention. No problem with that. Then, cold compress. This is a common point.
Cold compress.
It, see, for all these things, I want you to note separately and then prepare note for yourself. Then only it will be helping for you. Then blood test, everything is normal. No need to mention. Medical record, see, it's leg in, this is leg injury particularly. In that case, we have to mention this is the latest treatment. So we will be writing that.
The name of the surgery also we have to mention in
yes.
that letter.
Here from here, so we don't have to actually take much point because it's not related to our treatment. Sometimes in the old patient, they often forget to take medications. That is, almost all patients, they are suffering from the same problem. That anxious point, forget medicine. See, here in the medicine list, it's like only one drug. That is like a, see, this is related to leg injury, bone injury, and that's the reason why we will be taking this medicine. And no allergy is a common point. Sometimes they will be telling that this patient is particularly sensitive to codeine. Any drug name they will be mentioning, and then how we can change that to a sentence. Now otherwise will be there is no allergy. There is no known case of allergy. Like that also we can write, because in the sample which you will already have, all these things will be available, but it won't be order. But students will be preferring different sentence for each student. So that's the reason why you have to make the note for yourself. That's all our question. You can read the first paragraph. Okay, so there will be several ways even you can write this, because what I am planning is that I will try to I already uploaded one video related to this accident case. This will be the second video. So it's like I am trying to combine and study like that is that. So I want to understand if any common points will be there. You people also can understand. So that's the reason why I think whatever questions are available, I am planning to make into a series. So this is the second accident case. Mostly accident cases could be transfer. It's not always necessary. So keep that point also with you. So when you combine different transfer letter, You will be getting a comfortable transfer paragraph. Now I know you prepared a discharge paragraph for you. So you will be applying that. Similarly, you can apply by comparing, you can also take. See, this paragraph, this sentence you could use for the next transfer letter also. So Miss Mellers was admitted on date. See, if it is if you are not mentioning the year, it will be 10th. 10th, that TH should be there. On 10th, after being knocked.
Knocked.
Yes, it's like after being knocked by a mobility scooter. See, how to tell bone fracture? Breaking her wrist. And see, I'm stressing over here because it will be important. You have to apply all these things. Next also, they will bone only will break. Next accident also. See the preposition to her legs. It's not on her legs. Last video also I explained, because suffering and cuts and bruises to her legs, not on her legs. It's happening, cuts and bruises to her leg. Otherwise, that's the best preposition which you can use, because this preposition why I'm stressing is that because we can make mistake over there. She is now ready to be transferred. See, transferred to your retirement home. Were, usage of were, because were is a good connector which combine two sentences and make it a long sentence. Were she will be leaving as of tomorrow. See, as of tomorrow, normally we won't get as of tomorrow and all. So it's good if you can write. And I know if you read two times, everyone will get. Mrs. Mellor is an active 77-year-old. See how they wrote 77-year-old. There is a hyphen over here. 77-year-old. It won't be 77 years old. It will be 77-year-old, like this hyphenated. That is important. You shouldn't avoid all those things. Widow with. Actually, this patient is only suffering from bone related issue and no any other issues. How to write that? Because only one problem she is facing. It's not some case letter, it will be hypercholesterolemia, hyperemia, like that. Several things will be there. But that's not the case. Sometimes they won't be suffering any other problems. How to write? With no current morbidities means disease, illness. So like that, you have to understand. With no current morbidity except, usage of except. See, all these things, it's difficult to use. We won't think when we are at the examination time. Except osteoporosis. For which, for that, she is taking, she takes continuous tense, she is takes calcitonin. Her son, if you want, you can include her son, comma, who lives. See, the usage of who, it's good, because I told you who, where, when. All these are good points where you get mark. Her son, who lives nearby, is very present in her life. Because in this case, it's like mostly what we in the letters we can, when we observe, it will be social isolation, one common point, repeated point. But here someone is her, therefore helping her, is very present in her life. Now read the next para.
Okay,
she has been instructed, the usage of has been. So I encourage students to use when they are checking or when they are practicing. At that time, do they have written some sentence with has been? So these are like, okay, the sentence structure itself, it will be better. Nothing to remember, you don't have to worry all this. She has been, he has been instructed. This is a common sentence which is all students using. It's nothing new. So automatically some grammar points will be there. She has been instructed. In ED, this is past tense. Been means past tense. She has been instructed to continue some medicine, they have to continue with a twice daily. How they wrote twice daily? Twice per day or twice daily, hyphenated. Application of Medihoney ointment on her legs. See, when we are talking about body parts, it's like on her wound, on her legs, on her hand. Where you will make this preposition mistake in your speaking section, there you won't be thinking. We have to continuously tell, otherwise your fluency won't meet. At that time, in you have to understand this on her legs, on her body, and like that. The wrist operation was successful. How they wrote all every text, every test, every further test is normal. All tests were absent one way. All parameters are now normal. See, now normal parameters, good vocabulary. They will be, see here one vocabulary, vocabulary morbidity. See, morbidity. So here parameters, it's not mentioned, these parameters and all, it's not mentioned in the case note which they have given. It's only here new words we are adding. It's not like we are just copying the same sentence. Now, if necessary, in the question it was as required. Now how we change if necessary? As required, we can change to if necessary. So that's how we have to change, because now it will be naproxen, next case it will be paracetamol. Same sentence you can go, if necessary she has painkillers, the drug name, which can be taken twice a day, BD, which can be taken twice a day. She should also be encouraged. See, encouraged, there it was encouragement, I guess, I think so, encouraged to, see they changed that, they didn't went for writing the complete change, they just changed according to them. ED only they changed, added, encouraged to continue taking her osteoporosis medication. Related to bone, we took that. Now read the last para. One second. This is the date, right? First one, 20. They are not using that vocabulary appointment, okay? But when they are writing the third paragraph, they are using appointment. See, extra word which we added, appointment, okay? Appointment. So some sentences will be repeated, appointment, you can see in the samples. Mrs. Mellis has an appointment, an appointment. If I teach you like this, your grammar mistake will be less. And the correction will be also less for me. Has an appointment on date at outpatient. Outpatient repeated point for the removal of her stitches. See, accompany point will be common. Some, there are several ways. Please arrange for her to be, usage of to be accompanied. Several sentences will be there, go for one. In addition, see this is the connector they have used. You have to use the connectors like in addition, additionally, in spite of, however. She should attend physiotherapy outpatient 3 times per week. Twice per week, 3 times per week and all. She will need help with her daily activities. Okay. Above all, in keeping the wrist, wound is common. I told you, you learned different sentence, I guess so. Remain, wrist dressing clean and dry. But also please aware, she must refrain. So I told you, you're remembering, I guess, so refrain, vocabulary to
stop someone from doing something.
Yes, refrain from heavy lifting. So go for that. Please be aware. See, new word, please not, kindly not, kindly collaborate, please be aware. Like that, it will be greatly appreciated. So several vocabulary has been instructed. It is highly recommended that, it is highly suggested that. So all these sentences you can, when you are writing a sentence, this type of, which start with something like this type of sentence, so the word count will be more. We would be grateful if you could, so there are several ways each paragraph would be written. We would be grateful if you could help her through this initial period of difficulty. If you have any queries, please contact me. Only learn one sentence, don't learn everything. So if you are learning like this, I think it will be easy for you. Thank you.